The very first Shell Ecomarathon was held in 1985 in the foothills of southern France. Over the next 28 years, it's become more than just a competition. It's developed into an event that's integral to the exploration of alternative energies and fuel efficiency. In 2007, the Americas joined in, making it a more global challenge. This year, students from Brazil, Canada, Mexico, and for the first time, Guatemala, will converge on Houston. From early on in Shell Ecomarathon Americas, Louisiana Tech University has been the team to beat. They've been winning titles and breaking records with their innovative cars. Professor Heath Timms is the driving force behind this team.
When I first heard about the Shell Ecomarathon America 6 years ago, I knew this was something that we wanted to get our students involved in. It was a way that we could inspire them to take what they learn in the classroom and use it in a real world project.
We have a great group that gets straight to work on things, and we're willing to stay up until the middle of the night because we're very passionate about what we do. Attributed to our success more than anything else is the dedication that our team members show.
In 2007, we started the Ecomarathon team, and our first car is now known as the Blue Diamond. Our real goal for that year was just to make it to the competition. And not only did we have fun and do well, we ended up turning a lot of heads.
Former Louisiana Tech student Colin Hostly was part of the original team that took the Blue Diamond to the competition.
Little bitty tiny bicycle frame, gasoline-powered, three-wheeled engine vehicle.
For Colin, his involvement in the Shell Ecomarathon was a window into his future. He is now an employee of Shell.
I was able to get an internship with Shell, and then after that, found the group that I wanted to work in. And sure enough, here I am in that group and enjoying my job as we speak.
We have a great need for engineers and scientists in the decades to come. Shell has the aspiration to actually have all the talented people around the globe competing against each other, but also learning from each other.
Shell Ecomarathon Americas has come a long way since 2007, when just 17 teams competed in California.
Start your fuel-efficient engines. Good luck.
This year, over 100 teams will be in Texas competing in six different energy classes. Gasoline, diesel, fatty acid methyl ester, ethanol, battery electric, and hydrogen. And two vehicle categories, prototype and urban concept. Louisiana Tech compete in two of these categories, the diesel urban concept class and gasoline prototype class. Over the last 5 years, they have created some of the most pioneering designs at the event.
My goal has always been to design super efficient, eye-catching vehicles. The idea is to marry together function as well as aesthetics.
Shell Ecomarathon pushes the latest Louisiana Tech recruits to explore the most innovative materials and cutting-edge technology.
Spacer. I'm a freshman, so it's definitely teaching me a lot more, a lot faster than I would have learned otherwise.
You tell somebody you built a car that did 640 miles to the gallon, and they're interested automatically.
In 2012, LUTEC created their best prototype yet. Thunder Dog is lighter, more aerodynamic, and unlike most Ecomarathon cars, uses front-wheel drive. But this groundbreaking design had a problem.
The driver was going around a corner. He was doing about 30 to 35 miles per hour at the time. We're trying to see when our vehicle is going to come back around, and when he doesn't, then you get a little concerned.
The front wheel drive and rear wheel steering had dramatic consequences for driver Brandon Cloud.
The back end hit a pothole and stopped the back tire, and the car just kept going, and it flipped over like that.
But safety for Heath and the LUTEC team is as important as design aesthetics.
The driver was unhurt, nothing happened to them, and that's really a testimony to how we build our cars.
This year, Thunder Dog has been modified, and the team has high hopes of winning the 2013 gasoline prototype class.
Every year, we want to set the bar somewhat higher, and therefore new records will drive them to new thinking and new challenges.
The Louisiana Tech team continues to push technology further.
Of course, we're entering a new car for the 2013 competition, and our plan is to make it a real head-turner.
As in previous years, this urban concept car will use a carbon fiber skin. But for the first time, LUTEC is using a 3D modeling program to direct an automated routing machine to cut out a foam mold for the car's superstructure. But pushing techie boundaries comes with risks.
You know, we're watching the video and everything's just going fine, then the next frame, you know, the whole thing slid over here, then it slid over here, and 2 seconds later it's in five pieces and it's just going crazy everywhere and the bit's crooked and it was a nightmare. It did set us back some, but it really kind of made us focus more, and so it kind of gave us some drive to get going again so that we would still be on track and not fall behind schedule.
Despite this setback, the team is working hard on taking Houston by storm with this groundbreaking urban concept car.
We're always looking for ways to improve our vehicle, whether it's how we make our parts to optimizing engine performance. When the Shell Ecomarathon is in Houston, we're looking for the results monitors, and we're wanting to be on the top of that list.
The road to Houston, join the journey. See more films at Shell.com.